This morning I found my moon moths from Siberia clustered together. In front of you, you see one female, she's in the middle. And here we see two males. The difference between the male and the female is the tails. Males have much longer tails, while females have truncate and short tails. Either way, why are they so close together? The reason for that is because last night, here we have one loner, last night they have probably paired, which means they made love, and the female is probably fertilized right now. I thought it would be interesting to show you. So the difference between male and a female, let's see. It may remind some American viewers of the Actias Luna, the American moon moth. They are related, but totally different species. Here we see the male, here we see the female. And well, I think they did their best, and I really hope that she will lay plenty of eggs. It's kind of dirty old cage. I've been using these cages for like 5 years now, so maybe I should clean up my act. Either way, it looks messy, but it works fine, so I don't really care that the cage is dirty. They'll pair in it, as you see. Well, Actias artemis is not a species that I have bred before. Well, until today, that is, because I hope to change that. Let's put you here. Looks like the other male doesn't really want to be on camera. Maybe he's camera shy, I don't know. Either way, they should be easy to raise, and they eat a number of things like oak, like willow, ulmus. I forgot the English name for ulmus. Well, but it's a plant and it's rather common. So I'm gonna go zip up the cage now before they fly away. Thanks for watching, and with some luck, you'll see me raise these Actias artemis moths. Bye bye.